viewers, this is Veena for sulekha.com, and I've come back again to teach you a lovely dish called Kabuli Rice. I've taken 1 cup of Kabuli chana. You have to soak it overnight. So then the second step is you have to pressure cook it with a pinch of turmeric powder, 2 cups of water and salt to taste. So you pressure cook, the water is added to it. Pressure cook the soaked chana. To 3 whistles. When it's pressure cooked, you strain it and you keep aside, and this is Kabuli chana which is strained. It's boiled, it should be boiled very well, it should be soft in texture. The second step of this recipe, you take oil in a pan, you take enough oil to fry the bread. You have to cut the bread, 2 slices of bread, cut it into cubes and deep fry to golden. When this oil is hot, I'll fry the bread to golden. But if you're on a diet, you can even roast the bread and cut it into pieces. So this has to be fried. Then your cashews, 1 tablespoon cashews for garnishing the rice. We fry it to golden. Take 2 tablespoons of oil. When the oil is hot, we add the onions. Saute the onion to dark pink in color. Should be sauteed for 2 to 3 minutes. The raw smell of the onion should disappear. In the process, we add the ginger garlic paste, ginger, garlic and green chili paste. Take it in equal amounts. When aroma arises, yeah, there's a lovely aroma. Add the chana masala powder, turmeric powder, red chili powder, salt to taste. Add all the powders together, because if you add one at a time, they tend to burn up. Yeah, then the taste of the sabzi is very different. Yeah, add all the powders together. Saute just for a minute. Add the tomato puree, 2 tomatoes puree. Saute again till oil separates. Saute well. Can you see how well it's blending? Yeah. The raw smell of the tomato should disappear. It should blend very well. Add all your boiled vegetables with the boiled potato, beans, carrot, peas. Again, there's an option. You can add any vegetable you like. You can add zucchini to this. You can add corn to this pilaf. Add the boiled kabuli chana. Saute well. The potato should be cut into little big cubes. After you boil, you cut them into big cubes. A very strong aroma. It's a delicious rice which you can serve to your guests. And it's very nutritious because we are adding the chickpeas into it. Drop out the masala into a... Again, now you layer it. First layer masala, second layer rice. Repeat process with the masala. In between you can add your bread pieces. Add a few bread pieces and a few fried cashews. Repeat process with the rest of the rice. This serves four. Every recipe of mine will serve four. You can double your recipe if you have eight people to eat this rice. Here we go. Now what you have to do is make a hollow in the center of your rice. Here you are. Make a hollow in the center. Quarter cup of milk you add into the hollow. And cover it with the rice. Garnish it with coriander and leave it on dum. So the milk and the masalas, they blend into the rice and you get lovely aroma when you eat the rice. We kept the rice on dum and now we open the lid and you can see how well it is blended. You can see the lovely shading of the rice. Yeah. So you serve it. Now you can blend the rice. Use the back of your spoon because basmati rice tends to break. That's a tip again. Always use the back of the spoon when you or you toss the rice like this, or you can toss the rice, right? See, blended very well. And put it on our platter. It's highly nutritious. And garnish it with a few coriander leaves, finely chopped. The fried bread, decorated with fried bread. And a few cashews. It's a lovely dish which is made, Kabuli rice. Thank you.